Hi guys, it's Jessica and welcome to CritIC, the Pharmacokinetics series. If you haven't watched my video on clearance yet, I'd strongly recommend it before you dive into this one on metabolism. Metabolism is the hepatic contribution to clearance. The goal of metabolism is to make the drug more water-soluble so that it can be excreted. A drug is usually converted from an active substance to inactive metabolites. The reversal is also possible. Some drugs undergo metabolism to convert the inactive prodrug to the active drug. Most ACE inhibitors are prodrugs like these. In the context of clearance, this means that prodrugs are not cleared by the liver as they become active after metabolism. Also beware of toxic metabolites, which are usually inactive but damaging to the tissues. Metabolism happens in two phases, though some drugs only use phase 2. Phase 1 is the modification phase, and it's governed by cytochrome P450. This is a group of metabolic enzymes that break down xenobiotic compounds like drugs through reduction, oxidation, or hydrolysis. It's responsible for 75% of all metabolism. Pharmacokinetically, it is of interest because there is great genetic variability in the expression of these enzymes, and more importantly, it is involved in drug interactions because these enzymes can be induced or inhibited. Phase 2 consists of conjugation reactions, making the drug more water-soluble so that it can be excreted. Phase 2 reactions can be saturated, which is an important concept in toxicokinetics. Let's focus a bit on cytochrome P450. There are many CYP enzymes, but only 5 are responsible for the vast majority of phase 1 metabolism. These are CYP3A4, CYP2D6, CYP2C9, CYP1A2, and CYP2C19. If your drug is a substrate of these enzymes, inducing these enzymes will speed up the metabolic process, resulting in lower concentrations for drugs that are metabolized to an inactive form, which kind of sucks if it happens to be your antibiotic. Inhibiting these CYP enzymes will result in higher drug concentration and thus possible toxicity. For drugs that are transformed to their active counterparts, obviously inducers and inhibitors have the opposite effect. In my opinion, whenever you start medication, you need to know if your drug is a substrate, inducer, or inhibitor of a certain CYP enzyme, and review your patient's list of medication for this possible interaction. A good source with a list of medication and its corresponding CYP enzymes is the book called The Top 100 Drug Interactions, link in the description. Unfortunately for me, it isn't available in my country. So the online resource that I use is the Flockhart table by the Indiana University. I'll provide a link in the description for that as well. This video would be endless if I list all possible interactions, but we'll go through a few notable ones. For CYP3A4, beware when prescribing macrolides like clarithromycin and erythromycin, as they are strong inhibitors, resulting in higher serum levels of simvastatin, which could cause rhabdomyolysis. Carbamazepine, used for treating epilepsy, is a strong CYP3A4 inducer, which could lead to subtherapeutic levels of the birth control pill and thus undesired pregnancy. For CYP2D6, note that fluoxetine, commonly known as Prozac, is a strong inhibitor, which increases the level of risperidone, an atypical antipsychotic, thus increasing the chance of extrapyramidal side effects. For CYP2C9, note that fluconazole, an antifungal, is a strong inhibitor, which could lead to toxic levels of certain NSAIDs. For CYP1A2, it is important to know that ciprofloxacin is a strong inhibitor, causing a more than 5-fold increase and thus possible toxic levels of amitriptyline, a tricyclic antidepressant, and clozapine, an atypical antipsychotic. Also note that tobacco, i.e. smoking, is a CYP1A2 inducer. This means that if your patient uses clozapine and is a smoker, once he or she quits smoking, woohoo, the serum levels of clozapine will rise. Darn. This requires monitoring, and you might even want to consider a different antipsychotic agent if possible. And that wraps up this video on metabolism. Please let me know in the comments if it was helpful or not. Give it a thumbs up or share it. Now, on to the final video on excretion.